a couple social programs. So we do classes and workshops for adults. We have a kids program. We also have a free program for veterans, and we've been working with the Exceptional Children's Program, which is the special ed program at the Asheville Middle School. So our next set of classes starts up here in a couple weeks. I've got Anja Bartels here with me tonight. We're going to center 50 pounds of clay in under 5 minutes for you. Just want to mention, too, that Anya's going to be teaching a T-Tour Around the World class that starts October 20th. Really solid class. Michael Kenny is actually assisting with that too. So two great tea experts and two great potters in one phenomenal Monday morning class.
Wow.
You have anything to add?
All
right, away we go. Oh, thank you so much. We do a benefit auction each year, November 1st. You may have seen some of the preview items out front. We have tickets available tonight. You can talk to myself, to Anya, to Travis Winters, who's one of our other resident artists. Great event last year, really terrific party, and those 100% of the proceeds benefit the veterans program and the kids program that I just mentioned. So thanks so much for your kind attention. Thanks for coming out tonight. And without any further ado, so we're using Helios porcelain and on one of these whisper wheels. And we're going to do a team throwing contest. So we do this together. This is 25 pounds of clay. We're going to throw two 25-pound pieces of clay. When you do this, you can break it into whatever increment is most comfortable for you. So we're going to get to 50 pounds by two 25-pound pieces. You could certainly do five 10-pound pieces.
In under 5 minutes.
Yeah, 10 5-pound pieces. And we're going to try and do this. We practiced the other day, so I think we've got this in under 5 minutes. Okay, you ready to go? So in this technique, we actually learned this on YouTube, of all places. In the big pot factory in Jindijin, China, they throw hundreds of pounds of clay at a time, and they'll use two and sometimes even three people. So let's go up one more time. You have a lead and a follow. So the lead has their hands on the clay, and the follower, the assistant, is reinforcing their wrists. So you kind of have super hands. When you put your second piece of clay on, clean all the slip off of the top of the first piece of clay. And then also you don't want any indentations or any concave aspects to the top here, or else when you throw the second piece of clay down, you'll get an air bubble. And then this is kind of key too. Have a towel ready and dry your hands off when you do this. If any moisture gets underneath your clay, this top piece of clay can kind of hydroplane around on the bottom one. So we're going to go around physically twice here. And try, it's like when you're coil building, you got to make this line in between the two pieces of clay disappear, or else water can get up underneath that seam and make the top piece of clay kind of float around on the bottom. Was that 5 minutes? Not 5 minutes.
It's 3 minutes and 16 seconds.
That's right, we're going to get this. Under 5 minutes.
Now you've got an extra minute because we talked a lot.
All right, hopefully we won't need it. I think that's good. Should we go up one more time? Go up one more time. Just real slow down at the bottom. Okay. Good.
Dang it, I thought it goes.
This is like the professional potter's version of ghosts right here.
Oh, man.
Yeah, they say 100 pounds. Okay, and let's finish it off with that one forearm move. So you always want to work together. You don't want to work the same part of the clay in different spots or you're fighting each other. So we've been reinforcing our hands, and now Anya's going to work the top, and I'm going to work the side. If we both work the top, it gets all wonky. Okay, ease off. I'm going to call that centered. What's the time?
That looks good. Very good.
All right. So that's it. And if your wheel can handle it, you can keep going. We have a 200-pound platters in the building that are drying. One's in Anya's studio, the other one's in mine in the corner. And we just did a 70-pound platter because the 100-pound platters are too large for any of our kilns. A meter wide If anybody here tonight has a kiln that has a full meter wide, like 1 meter by 1 meter, please come talk to us. Because we're trying to figure out how to fire these things. But again, welcome. Thank you so much. Feel free to go anywhere in the studio. If you have any questions, just let us know.
Thank you.
So much. Yeah.